Monsters, Inc. The book. From Disney Pixar. Okay. Here's the book. Here's Monsters, Inc. There's Sully and Mike. Late one night, a little boy awoke to see a monster. Boy screamed. There's the monster. Then the monster screamed too. With a sigh, the scare teacher turned off the mechanical boy and the simulator machine. Then she reminded the students of Monsters, Inc., of the rules: never scream and never leave a child's closet door open. A child could get into Metropolis. The students knew that the screams they collected from human kids powered the city. But they also knew that children and their belongings were toxic. Meanwhile, across town, James P. Sullivan was exercising. His assistant, his best friend, Mike Wazowski, stood by, nearby, coaching him. Sully, as Sullivan was called, was a professional scarer at Monsters, Inc. He needed to stay in top shape for physical demands of his job. "Feel the burn," Mike urged. "You call yourself a monster?" He's urging him to work harder. Sully was famous for collecting more screams than any other monster. His scaring skills were especially important now that the city was in the middle of an emergency shortage. Human kids were getting harder to scare, and Metropolis needed all the screams it could get. In the locker room at Monsters, Inc., Mike and Sully prepared for their workday. A chameleon-like monster named Randall suddenly appeared. "Ah," Mike shrieked. Randall was creepy and mean, and was very jealous of Sully. Randall would do anything to be the company's top scarer. As the monsters made their way to the scare floor, they passed Roz, who was in charge of all the paperwork. Mike was always late with his paperwork. "I'm watching you, Wazowski," Roz growled at Mike, always watching. There she is, watching. So we got on the scare floor, a giant conveyor belt dropped the child's closet door into each scare station. The scarer entered the child's bedroom through the door, then did his best to scare the child and collect the screams. Sully walked in on a slumber party. He scared all the kids and filled many canisters with screams. As Sully's scream total shot to the top of the scare leaderboard, Randall snarled. He hated coming in second. Anyways, being lazy. Suddenly, an emergency bell rang. A scarer named George had returned from the human world with a child's sock on his back. In seconds, a squad from the Child Detection Agency, also known as the CDA, arrived to decontaminate him. Poor George. While the scare floor was shut down for cleanup, Sully talked to Mr. Waternoose, the head of Monsters, Inc. Mr. Waternoose was worried that the company couldn't supply enough power for the city. To help out, Sully promised to demonstrate proper scaring techniques to the new scare recruits. Jeez. After work, Mike rushed to meet his girlfriend, Celia, for dinner, but Roz blocked his way. "I'm sure you've filled your paperwork, right?" raps the cranky clerk. Mike had forgotten. Now he was going to be late for his date with Celia. Luckily, Sully offered to file the paperwork for him. When Sully went back to the scare floor to get the papers, he noticed that someone had left the door out. He peeked inside but didn't see any monsters. Then something grabbed his tail. It was a child. Oh, there she is. Sully tried to toss the little girl back into her bedroom, but she wanted to play. She giggled and chased Sully around, calling Kitty. Sully finally managed to put the child into a duffel bag. He raced back to the scare floor and saw Randall. The sneaky monster pushed a button and sent the girl's door back to storage. What was Sully going to do? Sully went to the restaurant where Mike and Celia were having dinner. As he tried to explain what was going on, the child got out of the bag. "Boo!" she shouted, giggling. All the monsters screamed. Then when the CDA arrived, Mike and Sully scooped the girl up in the takeout container and ran. At their apartment, Sully and Mike tried to keep their distance from the girl. They were terrified of her. Then Mike tripped, and the little girl laughed. As she giggled, the lights in the room burned brighter and brighter until they burned out with a pop. If that happened again, the CDA would surely find them. after a long night. Sully put the child into bed, but she was afraid that something was in the closet. She drew a picture of what scared her. It was Randall. Sully stayed with her until she fell asleep. Then he went to talk to Mike. "This might sound crazy," he said, "but I don't think the kid's dangerous. What if we just put her back in her door?" The next morning, Sully disguised the girl as a little monster. Then he, Mike, and the girl all walked straight into Monsters, Inc. Sully told everyone that she was a relative. They believed him. As Mike tried to figure out how to find the girl's door, Randall showed up. Sully and Mike heard him order his assistant to get the machine up and running. Then he said he would take care of the girl. Sully knew that the girl, whom he had started to call Boo, needs to go home quickly. In the hallway, Mike was cornered by Randall. Where's the kid? He demanded. Mike said he didn't know, but Randall didn't believe him. Randall told Mike that he would have the kid's door waiting on the scare floor so he could get back to the human world. Sully was worried when he heard the plan. To prove it was safe, Mike went through Boo's door first and was captured by Randall. Sully and Boo quietly followed Randall to a hidden laboratory. Randall had invited a scary-looking machine that invented a scary-looking machine that would pull screams out of kids, and he was about to test it on Mike. Sully rescued Mike just in time. The friends raced to warn Mr. Waternoose about Randall's evil plans. Waternoose was shocked to see Boo. "It's not our fault, it's Randall's," Mike cried, but Waternoose already knew about Randall's plan, because he was in on it. He grabbed Boo and shoved Sully and Mike through an open door and into the human world, where they were banished from Metropolis. Oh no. Mike and Sully ended up in the Himalayas, where they met another banished monster, the Abominable Snowman. But Sully didn't want to chat. Boo needed help. He made a sled and raced toward the local village, where he found a closet door that led him back to Monsters, Inc. Sully burst onto the scare floor. He ran to the secret lab, where he smashed Randall's horrible scream extractor machine to pieces. As Sully escaped with Boo, Mike caught up with him. Sully, Mike, and Boo were on the run from Randall. To slow Randall down, Sully announced over the loudspeaker that Randall was the new top scarer. The mean monster was instantly mobbed by cheering co-workers. Randall could only watch him frown as Sully, Mike, and Boo jumped onto the conveyor belt. Suddenly, the power went out, and the conveyor belt stopped moving. Randall was able to make his way closer to Mike, Sully, Boo, and Boo by jumping from door to door. "Make her laugh," Sully shouted. Mike quickly made some silly faces. When Boo giggled, the power returned. Randall still managed to catch up with them. He grabbed Boo, but she fought back. "She's not scared of you anymore," Sully said. Finally, Mike and Sully kicked Randall through a door and then smashed it. He was gone for good. Next, Sully and Mike tricked Mr. Waternoose into talking about his evil plan as Mike recorded him. "I'll kidnap 1,000 children before I let this company die," Waternoose shouted. Soon everyone in Metropolis had heard about Waternoose's wicked plan. He was arrested by the head of the CDA, who turned out to be Roz. It was time for Boo to go home. The little girl gave Mike a hug before following Sully into her room. He gently tucked her into bed. Sadly, Sully said goodbye and returned to Monsters, Inc. Roz ordered the CDA to shred Boo's door. It couldn't be used for scaring anymore, which meant Sully would never be able to visit Boo again. Sully became the new president of Monsters, Inc., and the scare floor became a laugh floor instead. Sully solved the energy shortage by proving that kids' laughter produced more power than their screams. And Mike became the company's top laugh collector. One day, Mike had a big surprise for Sully. He had put Boo's door back together. Sully opened the door, and Boo called out, "Kitty!" The friends were reunited at last.
The end.
The end.